It was exactly 1 year ago when Roman Reigns joined hands with Paul Heyman, and the alliance has turned out to be gold. On the first anniversary of their alliance, Paul Heyman has sent a very special message to his tribal chief. Heyman sent out the following tweet, claiming that he was rescued by Roman Reigns. He went on to praise the Universal Champion before ending with a bold statement that they have just begun. Exactly 1 year. I was rescued by WWE Roman Reigns. In the 52 weeks that have transpired since then, the hashtag Tribal Chief has redefined the medium, disrupted the status quo and sick titled the axis of what it means to be the top superstar in a WWE, and we've only just begun, wrote Paul Heyman in his tweet. Roman Reigns returned at WWE SummerSlam 2020 last year after a hiatus and attacked The Fiend Bray Wyatt and Braun Strowman. The next week on SmackDown, it was revealed that Reigns has now joined hands with Paul Heyman. A move that shocked the entire WWE universe, Paul Heyman has since served as the special counsel to the Tribal Chief, being by his side all the time. Ever since Roman Reigns joined hands with Paul Heyman, fans have wanted to see the reaction of Heyman's former client and Reigns' arch-rival Brock Lesnar. Last week at WWE SummerSlam 2021, the Beast Incarnate finally made his long-awaited return to WWE and confronted the Universal Champion. The expressions on both Roman Reigns and Paul Heyman's faces were priceless. This past week on SmackDown, WWE started the build to this major feud as the Usos accused Paul Heyman of knowing about the return of Brock Lesnar. Heyman denied the accusations and claimed that he will remain by the side of the Tribal Chief. There are clear tensions between Heyman and the Bloodline, but Roman Reigns has been surprisingly calm so far. Is it the calm before the storm? What will happen when Brock Lesnar returns and destroys Roman Reigns in the ring? What are your thoughts on Roman Reigns and Paul Heyman's alliance? Do you think Heyman will turn on Reigns and go back to Brock Lesnar? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. Alexa Bliss recently clapped back at a fan after the latter criticized her current gimmick on WWE TV. Alexa Bliss has done it all in pro wrestling. She is currently donning a supernatural persona on WWE Raw, and her gimmick has received quite a mixed response from the WWE universe so far. The official Twitter handle of WWE Network recently posted a throwback clip of Alexa Bliss' Raw Women's title win over Sasha Banks on the August 28, 2017 episode of Raw. A fan responded to the clip by hinting that she has had quite a fall and is currently playing with a doll. Alexa Bliss noticed the fan's tweet and decided to hit back with a clever response to the same. Bliss had the following to say to the fan, "Yep, I sure do, and Lily is available on a WWE shop, well, when she's back in stock. Keep selling out, darn," tweeted Alexa Bliss. Alexa Bliss was targeted by Bray Wyatt's alter ego, The Fiend, on WWE SmackDown last year. She became possessed by the sinister entity and soon turned into a disturbed and deranged character. Both Alexa and The Fiend made their way to Raw during the WWE draft, where the duo kicked off a feud with Randy Orton. At WrestleMania 37, Alexa Bliss' distraction helped Randy Orton defeat The Fiend. Bray Wyatt was let go by WWE a while ago. Bliss introduced a doll named Lily to the WWE universe, and the pairing didn't sit well with a lot of fans. The biggest criticism of Bliss' gimmick has been that she possesses supernatural powers, which makes it hard for many fans to suspend their disbelief. Interestingly, Alexa Bliss doll is doing quite well in terms of sales on the WWE shop, and the former Raw Women's Champion acknowledged the same in her retort to the fan. What do you think of Alexa Bliss' current character and Lily the doll? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. Alexa Bliss recently opened up on a possible career as an actor. Speaking with ET, she opened up on a possible acting career in the future, and had the following to say, "WWE will always be home, that's always where I'll be, but I would love to see what happens if I go for acting. Like, I've been working with an acting coach for the last 10 months. Everything I'm doing right now, character base-wise, is a lot of acting, and it's a lot of fun. But I would love to try that one day if the cards allow, that would definitely be a passion of mine, but for now, WWE's home," revealed Alexa Bliss. Alexa Bliss is currently donning the persona of a disturbed entity that possesses supernatural powers. Although many fans aren't thrilled with Bliss' character, she has received major critical acclaim for her portrayal of the character. Alexa Bliss made her debut on WWE's main roster in 2016. She was immediately pushed as a top name and went on to become SmackDown Women's Champion. Bliss has done fine for herself on WWE Raw as well, having won 5 women's titles across the 2 main roster brands so far. Alexa Bliss is also a 2-time WWE Women's Tag Team Champion and is a former Money in the Bank briefcase holder. Bliss' transformation into an evil entity last year on SmackDown gave her something fresh to work with, and it's safe to say that she has nailed the role in every way. The former women's champion is quite popular among the WWE universe, and even though her current character is not popular with some fans, she is moving tons of merchandise on a regular basis. Alexa Bliss has shown in the past year or so that she has what it takes to kick off an acting career somewhere down the line. Do you think Bliss will follow in the footsteps of WWE greats like The Rock and John Cena in the near future, and try her hand in Hollywood? Would you like to see Alexa Bliss revert back to her previous character, or do you prefer the supernatural entity she is portraying at the moment? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. WWE superstar Liv Morgan appeared for an interview during Talking Smack to discuss her match on SmackDown this week. Morgan told Kayla that she was happy to have pushed Bianca Belair to her limit. She was also excited to have eliminated a former women's champion in Carmella during the Fatal 4-Way Elimination match. Morgan shared a short conversation she had with Becky Lynch over a year ago when the man was taking some time off for her pregnancy. She detailed that Becky told her that she would be the women's champion by the time Lynch returned. The rising star stated that she was excited to hopefully fulfill that prophecy. Morgan added that it would be even better if she could take the title from Becky Lynch. "You want to know a little secret? When Becky left, I gave her a hug goodbye," she whispered in my ear. "When I come back, you are going to be champion. I've thought about that every single day. She's back, and I'm not champion, but I'm looking so forward to proving her right. Maybe not on her timeline, but I'm going to be a champion, and I'd love to take it off of Becky Lynch." Liv Morgan had a great outing on the Blue brand this week. She participated in a Fatal 4-Way Elimination match to determine the number one contender for the SmackDown Women's Championship. The former Riot Squad member eliminated Carmella and was one of the last two women remaining in the ring. The EST of WWE ultimately picked up the win with a kiss of death. After the match, Liv Morgan stated that although she came up short, it still felt like a win to her because she brought the best out of Belair. Would you like to see Liv Morgan as the SmackDown Women's Champion? Let us know in the comments below. Raw superstar Riddle has thrown some serious shade at WWE Universal Champion Roman Reigns in a recent interview. Outspoken WWE superstar Riddle has lashed out at WWE Universal Champion Roman Reigns, but it's safe to assume he was just trolling. Either that or he has a death wish. During a recent chat with Bleacher Report's Graham Matthews, the Raw roster member called into question Roman's claims that he's a needle mover, and said he could beat the SmackDown star in a real fight. "No disrespect to Roman, he seems like a swell fella, but at the same time, it's like when people say they're a good parent," Riddle said. "You know what, if you were a good parent, your kids would be telling you you're a good parent. When he's saying acknowledge me, or I move the needle, no, you don't. You're related to The Rock, shut up, like, I'm not impressed. I can beat you up in a real fight, so, shut your mouth," he added. Riddle's trash talk comes off the back of Roman's recent proclamation that he's responsible for the fact that this year's SummerSlam was the most watched SummerSlam in the history of the event. Legitimate needle moving, Reigns tweeted shortly after the numbers were announced. "You're not moving needles, I'm the real stallion, RK-Bro is moving the merch, we're moving the needle, and that's it," Riddle continued in the aforementioned Bleacher Report interview. "I don't want to say too much, I'm not trying to get in trouble. Hey, hats off to him. He's amazing at what he does. I do like what he does, but at the same time, it's like, get off your high horse. You're in that spot for a reason. You're not a bro. You're second generation. I'm first generation." It's not the first time that Riddle has run his mouth off at a more senior superstar. As you might recall, the original bro had some awkward backstage encounters with Goldberg after calling the WWE Hall of Famer out on multiple occasions.